My name is Silvio Cioni. I'm a design director and teacher and the advisor of the Master in Service Design of Domus Academy Milano. Design thinking is one of the core courses of the Master in Service Design. Design thinking is both an approach and a process for design-driven and user-centered innovation. It's a structured approach that allows designers to empathize with users, clearly identify a problem, generate ideas, prototype, and finally validate them with the potential users. Through a series of theoretical lectures and practical activities, the Design Thinking course provides you a clear perspective on the subject and a practical framework to transform design challenges into opportunities for innovation through divergent and convergent thinking. The course will begin by providing an historical perspective of design thinking. In 1992, Richard Buchanan published a book entitled Wicked Problems in Design Thinking, reopening a long debate about the designer's ability to solve complex problems and how to apply this attitude within innovation processes. Probably it's the first time that the name design thinking has been used in the title of a book, but we have to wait more than 10 years before the design thinking process is formalized. In 2004, the Hasso-Plattner Institute of Design was founded at Stanford University. David Kelly, former chief executive officer of the design firm IDEO, is one of the founders of the Institute, better known internationally as the Stanford D School. It is at this school that the design thinking process acquires those attributes that still distinguish it today. Since its introduction as a methodology within the design disciplines, the approach has grown exponentially and is now applied to a wide range of activities from product development and to business strategy. In the design thinking course, we will explore in detail the five phases of the design process, and in each we will introduce different methods that could be suitable to better inform the following step of the process itself. The first phase of design thinking, called empathize, aims to understand the user's behaviors and identify their needs and goals. It is the phase in which the design team empathizes with the final users of the project. Define is the second phase of the process, and it's dedicated to identify opportunities by clarifying the needs of users and better framing the initial design challenge. The third, and probably the most important phase of design thinking, is ideate. It aims to generate different ideas of solutions which are able to meet the identified challenge. The goal of the prototype phase is to create a low fidelity version of specific features to accelerate the iteration of an idea. Finally, it is during the phase of test that the developed prototype is evaluated directly with end users. In the course, we will also introduce different approaches to better understand the differences and similarities with design thinking, such as the Double Diamond by Design Council and the Design Sprint created at Google Ventures. Design Thinking course is organized on two different streams. The first is characterized by introductory talks about the five phases and related design methods. The second one aims at developing in parallel a design project that allows to put process and methods into practice on a real design challenge. The course is structured to help you to think visually and learn system and experience mapping. A variety of design methods will be proposed and explored, from maps and flows to narrative and scenarios, to better understand the role of different techniques in relation to project development. The main goal of the course is to learn how design thinking works and to experiment a design-driven and user-centered approach to product service innovation that can be easily applied into personal design practice and with business organizations. Design thinking process and methods can be applied later in the following design workshop and in other extracurricular projects, such as marathons, competitions, boot camps of the master program itself. The course will also focus on future-oriented design practices. The last 5 years have witnessed the explosion of design futures. A set of practices, mainly speculative design, design fiction, and experiential futures, that for decades have been converging at the intersection of design and future studies. These practices share the view that the design methods and outputs can be used to foster conversations about the future. So this track will introduce you to speculative design, design fiction, participatory futures, and experiential futures, in order to explore non-traditional design practices for envisioning future scenarios and artifacts. These practices foster to reflect on the responsibility designers have to make sense of the complex and changing world, designing not just for the present, but also for more preferable futures. Future-oriented approaches encourage anyone to stretch imagination and generate alternative, more responsible and better visions for the future. In this part, you will learn to explore and interpret signals and drivers of change and to create scenarios and artifacts from the future. It will be an experimental track that will help designers to switch perspective and change their mindset towards the future in order to expand their design thinking toolbox.